Hello everyone. So in this video, we'll try to calculate the limit of this function. And so we want to see if limit fxy as xy tending to 0, 0, that is when we are approaching towards the origin, whether this limit exists or not. So our question is, does fxy limit xy tending to 0, 0 exist? So here, in this type of problem, at first let us check what is the degree of denominator and the numerator. So the degree of the denominator, degree of the numerator is 3, and the degree of the denominator is also 3. Now in this kind of cases, we will generally try to approach towards the origin by this curve y equal to mx. So we are approaching the origin by any straight line. So any straight line means y equal to mx. So let us substitute y equal to mx and see what happens. So if we approach origin by this line, then as x tending to 0, y is also tending to 0. So when we substitute this, we will get limit x tending to 0 x square, and in place of y we are substituting mx. So we will get m cube x cube and x cube. So the x cube got cancelled up. So limit x tending to 0 m cube plus 1. So now this term is independent of x, so the limit is m by m cube plus 1. Now for different value of m, we will get different value of this limit, but for limit to be exist, that has to be unique. So here we can clearly see that when we are approaching the origin from different direction. So suppose this is my xy plane and we are approaching the origin from different straight lines, the limiting value will be different. It will depend on m. Suppose we are approaching using y equal to 0, that means when m equal to 0, then the limit is 0. But when we are approaching when y equal to x, this straight line, that is m equal to 1, in that case the limiting value is m by m cube plus 1, that is half. But when we are approaching via y equal to 0, that is we are approaching via x axis, then our limiting value, then in this case m equal to 0, so our limiting value is also 0, as you can see, as we have calculated. So for different values of m, we will get different limiting value. That's why the limit does not exist. So for this function, this limit does not exist. Thank you.